due to four satellites minimum, it will also give you the elevation. And again, in addition to these three position coordinates, it will also give you the time when you traveled at this latitude, longitude, and at this altitude. So that has a lot of rich detail that is being recorded using these GPS units. Next one. One other thing, instead of looking at your trail horizontally, you can also look at your trail in terms of elevation. So you can create what we call this elevation profile, which shows how you have traversed in the jungle up and down. You can imagine that more than covering 2 kilometers flat, it's much more challenging to climb over a peak instead of just simply following a flat stream. So seeing the ups and the downs in that you have walked in the trail gives a good indication of the difficulty of the trail. Next one. Many of the GPSs come with electronic compasses built in, so not magnetic, but electronic ones, which also give you the direction. Not that useful, because you anyway see the direction of the movement through the triangle. Next one. Also very interesting in the GPSs is that will it give you the, depending on the time of the year and your exact position somewhere in the world, in the US, in India, it will exactly show you what is the time of sunrise and sunset. So you can clearly plan when to kind of plan or reach your campsite before it actually gets dark. You can also see the moonrise and the moonset in case you need to do some night trekking, whether the moon will be of any assistance, will it be an early moon or a late moon, will it be a new moon or a full moon, so you can kind of plan your mobility in the night. Next one. Okay, I think the next part of the presentation is all related to manipulation of maps, georeferencing of maps, how to download maps from GPSs, how to prepare maps on a PC, download them, how to kind of convert paper maps in georeferenced maps that you can download in the GPS and take along with you in the field. This is all quite technical. People who are really interested into this, we're organizing like a more detailed workshop like on a 3-4 monthly basis. So just stay tuned to the mails flowing through the group, and you can join one of these 3-4 hour sessions to go a little bit more in depth. It's a little bit dry material, but I mean, it's all like, I mean, quite basic. It's not that, I mean, rocket science. And it's all very useful. I mean, if you really get familiar, if you get comfortable with those maps, you get comfortable with those GPS receivers, they are not that complex to use. It really makes it, I mean, a lot of fun, because then you don't really have to depend on the existing trails. You don't have to depend on organizers who have gone through the place before you. You can just take a map of any place. You can take a GPS, and you can just traverse according to your own will. You can basically create your own trail. You can explore new places, and you can really find, discover beautiful waterfalls, beautiful forts, jeep trails, and all the places which we have seen. So I hope that was still a little bit interesting at this late time of day. Any questions from anyone? That's a little heavy, I guess.
Peter, this Terra Incognita is not working anymore.
Should be working. Sometimes I've seen some problems, like Google Maps, sometimes it doesn't work. I think with Terra Incognita, which we used to capture Google Maps, download it in GPS system, doesn't work. It's typically some problem with the backend that Google Maps are down sometimes during during some maintenance periods, I guess. But it works most of the time. Yeah.
So Peter, I actually have a Flymaster device for my, which gives me GPS data. It's another brand. So all I get is GPS data. This device cannot be used to kind of transpose maps into it. Is there a way, is there a device which I can use for maps and just kind of get the GPS data into a simple device like that?
So you're asking about vendors or models which have GPSs which support topographic maps, I mean that you can...
Yeah, or a model which doesn't support GPS, it just shows me, it processes information of GPS data and can overlay on a map.
I mean, according to me, most of the GPSs, even like these basic eTrex, like a very cheap unit of Garmin, they all have map capability, because without map capability, I would say a GPS is useless. It's like looking at the blank screen, you'll just see your triangle, here I am, and you don't have any reference points, so it's totally useless in navigation. The only thing that it does is it might be recording the trail, so when you come home you can extract the trail and you can see on the Google map, okay, this I've walked this trail, but it's basically useless for navigation. So according to me, all of the units should really support downloadable maps. Of course, different vendors support different map formats. So I think we need to sync up a little bit, like what's the vendor, what is the format supported of the maps?
No, it's this device is used for a different purpose. You don't really need to know the terrain, you just need to know your endpoints. So you try to go to those endpoints, and the route which you use is not really land, so the terrain
doesn't
matter.
Yeah, I mean, you have different GPSs for different purposes. You have the core GPSs where you are okay with having the roads. You have the portable GPSs which we use for like off the trail where you need contour maps. You might have GPSs for other purposes where you really don't bother about loading maps, where you just want to go in the field. You want to take some measurements maybe for certain purposes. So I guess it could be one of those units that it's not really meant for navigation or using along with maps. But we can stay in touch through email, and you can just give me a little more details on that model. I can take a look and see what it could be useful for.
Thanks.
Yeah.
We can see the altitudes in using the contour lines, the GPS maps. So similarly, can we measure the depths of some of the water bodies, like we are going for a biking or we are going through jeeps, we might cross some of little water bodies, between them. So is that possibility we can see the depth of the water bodies through GPS?
Well, I mean, when you say depth of water bodies, that's like very regional, right? Depends on the water flow. I mean, Nagala West is like having a rush of water after the monsoon. In the summer, it won't be nearly dry. So
how do you really make sure that we can cross through bikes or through jeeps? Is it through the history? Through the history before, like the previous treks, or through some other?
It's a good question. I mean, so whatever you have seen on this map, I told you, like many times we use Google Maps. Google Maps actually takes the same data from SRTM. So it's 90 meters. 90 meters is fairly rough, right? One pixel on your screen is like 90 meters. 90 meters is maybe twice or thrice the size of this room. So hey, that's just one little pixel on your screen. So what I'm trying to say is that these maps are pretty rough still, even though they are the best available, they are still very rough. So I've seen, even though on the maps you don't see anything, you might be, when you go in the field and start building experience, when you start exploring a new mountain range, you might easily encounter like a waterfall of 50 meters, which is simply invisible on the map. So from experience, like of 4 years of trekking, of so many weekends, 100 plus treks, I could easily say that maps are very useful, but I think 60 to 70% you can use the map, 30% you will only get to know when you're in the field, like depth of the streams, the water flow, vertical drops, right? We humans, we are just like 1.5 meters, so any vertical drop with verticals on your left, right, verticals in front of you of 4 or 5 meters is enough to kind of be a dead end for you. So definitely, 30% you need to go to the field, assess the situation. You'll discover stuff which are not visible in the map. And it's like a combination, yeah. But with a map, at least you have 60, 70% clarity on the terrain. So it helps a lot, especially main valleys will be clearly visible. The ridges will be clearly visible. But that's also part of the fun. If you go on a CTC exploration treks, that 30% makes the fun, because you will suddenly be deadlocked. You will have to start finding a way around to climb around that 80 meter fall. And you can't jump down, obviously. You can't jump in the water because you don't know how deep the water is at the bottom of the fall. So you will have to start working on a trail around it to go back from the top of the fall to the bottom of the fall. That makes it all very thrilling and very interesting to discover unexpected places after the next turning, and then assess, say, how do I navigate around these physical obstacles.
Thank you, Peter, for sharing all your valuable experiences on maps, GPS navigation. And a big thank you on behalf of all CTC members. If not for you, many of the gorgeous waterfalls, forts and gorges in South India would have still remained unexplored. I now request Sabha to facilitate Peter.
Oh, thanks, Sabha. 2 seconds of the camera. Oh, thanks. Thanks a lot. Oh, thank you.
I'll keep it.
Oh, yeah. Let's Bhavana talk for a few minutes.